What's up, YouTube? Jetforth here, and today this will be my very first build video ever. So why not kick it off with a bang with a 4 million DPS AR build? I did everything I could not to copy anybody else's builds, and also do everything I could to be prepared for all the incoming nerfs. And well, this is what happened. I know, I about crap my pants too. And also to show how hard hitting this set actually is, you can consistently body shot between 1.7 million and 2.1 million. Consistently. Did I say consistently? Okay, I know. Shut up and show me the build already. Alrighty, so I went with the Survivalist for the 15% AR damage and for the 15% protection from elites. Because what fun would it be slaying elites if they can slay you back just as easily? For the AR, I went with the custom P416 G3. I know, shocker, right? The main talent that I chose to go with for this build is Ranger. Every 5 meters you are from the target grants plus 2% weapon damage. Ranger requires 4 or less utility. Lego things. I am only running one. I honestly believe that Ranger is overlooked, and this definitely allows you to do a lot of extra damage and is also not being nerfed into the ground. The second talent is Jazz Hands. I mean, it's alright. I would have much rather have had Optimized or Stable or even preferably Allegro, but hey, luck of the draw, RNG, what are you gonna do? The scope that I'm using is the C79, plus 5% damage to elites. A 5.56 muzzle break, also a plus 5% damage to elites. The laser pointer, plus 5% crit hit chance. And then finally, the light extended mag for plus 10 rounds. And now for a second slot, what I am pairing with that wonderful AR is the Nemesis, mainly for the holstered talent. Preparation, while holstered, gain plus 25% headshot damage when scoped with your current weapon. Now you can go with Chatterbox for the extra rate of fire, but I'll take the headshot damage and having a useful weapon in my second slot over than just having an exotic on you that is very not useful at all. For my sidearm, I have a double-barreled sawed-off, which is what it is, but mainly because it has stop, drop, and roll on it. Personally believe that any build should just have stop, drop, and roll on it. That's what I think anyways. And now on to gear. For my chest piece, I am using Fenris Group AB with Unstoppable Force. Killing an enemy grants 2% weapon damage for every 10,000 max armor. I would very much like to get my armor up a little bit more, a lot a bit more, but hey, luck of the draw, RNG, you know how it is. Unstoppable Force requires a 7 or more defense. And at this moment in time, it is safe from the nerf wagon coming through here very soon. It also has hard hitting on it, plus 15% damage to elites, and one defensive mod slot. For my holster, I'm also running a Fenris, which gives me the 10% assault rifle damage and an extra 10% protection from elites. This has precise, plus 15% headshot damage, and some health, and some crit hit chance. Precise is also safe from the nerf wagon. Next up, we have the knee pads, which I ended up with Gilligards. The reason why I'm using these is because of the amount of defense that rolled on them, and I needed to get that defensive blue shield deal up a lot more. But anyways, you get the plus 5% total armor, it rolled with plus bonus armor, hard hitting 15% damage to elites, and then two defensive mod slots. So overall, I thought it was a really, really perfect roll and a good fit. On to the gloves. I am using two Araldi Holdings, the backpack and the gloves, for the plus 10% accuracy and plus 10% headshot damage. Attributes, obviously, plus 10% assault rifle damage, and then there is Devastating, which I rolled onto them for the plus 5 weapon damage. Now, I could have easily went with hard hitting again, but I was noticing that I was having some issue actually knocking down the armor on the regular purple guy, so I did have to swap out hard hitting on a couple pieces. That's why you see Devastating and Precise showing up in two different spots in here. And again, an Araldi Holdings backpack for the plus 10% accuracy and plus 10% headshot damage. This was part of my old build. I still do want to run an Araldi, but this does have Safeguard on it, which is getting nerfed into the ground. I do not get to play the PTS, so I'm not sure how bad exactly it's going to be, but either way, Safeguard, it is unlocked on here because I have the 5 offensive. It has hard hitting on it and an offensive mod slot on it, which I cannot use, otherwise that puts me over the offensive for having Safeguard unlocked. So it'll do for now until I get something rolled better. Preferably, I would like to see an Araldi roll with something like this, with hard hitting and restorative, and a utility mod slot. That would be pretty keen, I think. And finally, the piece de la resistance is the mask, which I saved for last because I figured if I would have showed this first, you may take your phone and throw it across the room and be like, screw you, dude, how is that even possible? I am using a Providence defense mask, which is not my choice. I would rather it have been a DH with hard hitting on it, but if you look at it, it rolled with plus 40% damage to elites on it. I did not even know the damage to elites on something can drop that high. I had never seen that. So this may be really, really hard for people to recreate this build just based off of that. With this roll and hard hitting, I have plus 55% to damage to elites just off this one piece alone, which is why I'm hitting such high numbers. I mean, you could probably come close to where it's at, but I don't know. I can't even roll this off onto a DH, which, like I said, I would prefer to use that for the accuracy, but I mean, for real, I will take it. I'll take it all the way to the bank, if you will. So, I suppose we should take a look at the old stats sheet. We have 19,102 weapon damage, 16% crit hit chance, 32% crit hit damage. Now, they are nerfing down crit hit chance and crit hit damage. I do not know exactly to what. I believe it is going to be capped at 60, so I tried to keep it on the low side. 80% headshot damage, weapon handling 0, I would like to get that up, but the P416 is overall a pretty stable weapon. 5% all weapon damage bonus, 35% assault rifle bonus damage, then a bunch of stuff that doesn't really matter that does not pertain to this build, and the biggest one of all is 110% damage to elites. So I would say overall there is some room for improvement here, like the backpack and re-rolling some of the stats here and there, but again, it's up to RNG. So I don't know, let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Is there anything you would do differently? What do you think you would roll on the backpack? Are you going to try and make this build? Let me know. I'm really curious overall. But either way, hit the old like button for me if you could. That would be awesome. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed already and all that other junk, and I will catch you all on the flip side. Peace.